Alright guys, if you just stumbled across the crazy world of dropshipping, or maybe you've been starting and stopping stores because you've not been making enough money, this video is going to explain how dropshipping works in 2021 and what beginners should really look out for when they're starting out. Now in this video, I want to go over what dropshipping is and how it starts, the best way to make it happen, and of course, is it still worth it in 2021? And all dropshipping really is selling a physical product online. For example, a customer comes to our store, they pay this much for this product, we go to our supplier, we pay a lesser amount, and we ship it to the customer just by paying them. So we don't actually physically touch the product. That's the beautiful thing about dropshipping. So let's say, for example, I'll give you a quick example. This pressure washer right now from this store, Flash Discounts, they're selling it for £24.99, so £25. We can see we can get it on eBay for around £8. So the customer comes on the site here, they pay the 24, they come in here, we buy it for £8, and we pocket in about the £17-18. That's really all dropshipping is. We didn't touch the product, the customer got the product, they thought it was from us, and that's it. Now, before we really dive further into how and why, like, that should blow your guys' mind. Now, before we would have to go out there and pay thousands, if not tens of thousands, for actual physical stock up front, for rent, for a place, for warehouse fees. Now, this has took everything out of the equation here. We can literally profit from the start without going into the red. Well, the first thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need an actual place to host a website, because where the customer is going to put in the credit card details and check out and buy the item. So most commonly what people use is they use a platform called Shopify. Now why? Literally because when you tell people they need to go out and make a website, they get flustered. They're like, I don't know how to code, all that kind of stuff. With Shopify, you literally do not need to do any coding. You don't need any skills at all. All it is drag and drop. You can create some descriptions, you drag some images in, and you've got a fully working store in less than 30 minutes. Now, I made a video on this before where I literally built a store in under 30 minutes. I'm going to put that in the description in the first link. Go and watch that after we finish this video here. So if you're serious about dropshipping and you want to start, you can really see how to build a store. But anyways, after building a store, you're going to need this thing which is called domain, which literally, you know, for example, flashdiscounts.com. All that is a hosted domain so people can find your site. This is why I love Shopify, because they literally do it all for you. You just click a button, you buy the domain, and it's connected immediately. Now, probably the two most questions I get asked is, Jake, what products do I actually sell? And Jake, how do I go out and get customers to come to my store so they can check out? Now, to answer the question with what products you actually sell, to be 100% honest with you, it doesn't matter. You can sell literally anything. Now, what people mostly do is, I swear to God, I did this when I was starting out, when I was fully starting out with my first store. I started a jewelry, necklaces, bracelets, kind of store. I swear to God, everybody starts those kind of stores when they start out, or they'll start a sneaker store or some sort of t-shirt store. Now, not to say those stores simply can't work, like, look, we'll go back on the laptop here. We've got a bunch of people selling necklaces that are ranking on Google, so they're obviously getting sales. We've got some bracelets, for example. You know, these people are all running ads, which means they're paying money to get sales. So if they're paying money to be here, they're obviously going to be profitable. Problem with me, for example, and most other people that start these sort of jewelry stores, is the marketing. What they'll go out and do, and they'll go to Facebook ads, for example, they pay $5 a day, they'll do a free plus shipping offer. That's what we did anyways. And they just wouldn't get any sales. It's so hard to do that in 2021 with these little Facebook ads with just the image. Because honestly, nobody's really, you're gonna have to stick out like a sore thumb to get people actually to click on the store, let alone check out. And even if you do make sales, the chances are your sales just and your revenue, they just won't cover the cost you spent in ads and the product costs. You're probably gonna be making a loss. And what good is that in any sort of dropshipping store if you're just here to lose money? Now, what a better way to do now, just because of simply what I know, is to come on Google ads with these products. And we can see here they're selling these necklaces and bracelets all day long. Write a good description, have some good keywords in there, and you're going to rank in search and shopping pretty fast. And that's going to be a much better way, because people are typing in for these products. On Facebook ads, for example, it's so hard to make sales for these generic products. So this is why I really stress you can sell absolutely anything. You just have to make sure the marketing is in gel with the product. So if you're brand new and you haven't made a single sale yet, what I 100% recommend you do is start a general store. And I'll give you a bunch of reasons why. A lot of people will say, you know, go and start a niche store, go and start a one product store, for example, as well. Well, yes, that is good, but keep in mind, like, if you're starting all these one product stores, for example, and the product doesn't work, because chances are when you're just getting started, you're going to have to go through 10, 20, probably even 30 products to find a winning product. Now, can you imagine creating 30 Shopify stores, creating 30 domains, all this money you're going to have to put out there, when you can just start a general store, test a bunch of products, find what works, scale that up, and then yes, go and brand it, go and put it in a one product store. It's such a better way to test. Even now, I'm still running a general store on Google Ads, and I always will, because I think it's always best to find these winning products to go and create these other stores. If you do it the other way, I think you're doing it back to front. Another super important thing, and I get asked this all the time, is Jake, what budget can I realistically start with? They'd be like, Jake, I've got $50 to my name. I've never made a sale. How can I go and start a Shopify store? Now, if you've generally got $50 to your name, I don't want to be demotivating here, but it's probably not going to happen for you. Go and get a job, go and collect some money and put that into a store. Now, I did do 100K in 100 days with a $300 starting budget. I reinvested everything back in to get this 100K in revenue. We did about 24K in profit. Please keep in mind, I know I've been through all the mistakes. I knew exactly what to do from the start. If you're just starting out, you're going to be making all these mistakes. Now, like I said, not to be sound demotivating, but it's good to make these mistakes because you're going to learn so much faster. The more mistakes you make at the first hurdle, the quicker you're going to take that data back and you're going to be like, okay, I don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. And then eventually you're going to have, okay, this is all I need to do now. Because honestly, dropshipping in 2021, and if you're just starting out, you have to have a super strong mindset. There's going to be days where you want to quit. There's going to be days where you're going to get distracted and just, you know, not work on your store. That's fine, but just please remember, everybody else that's taking this 100% serious, they're going to absolutely destroy you. So you have to have these sleepless nights. You have to go through all these mental barriers. And once you keep pushing through, another one's going to pop up, but it's just going to be getting you closer and closer to that end goal. Another tip I want to give you is, once you do get 1K days, 5K days, do not go out there and flex. What you want to do with that money is you want to put that back in the business so you can get relentless. You can hire better people, you can run better ads, you can run more ads in different platforms, and you can really step away from the business while you're bringing all these people in. Because at the start on a dropshipping store, if you've got no budget, you're going to have to wear all these different hats. You're going to have to answer emails, you're going to have to fulfill the orders, you're going to have to do the product research, you're going to have to do the ads. Once you scale up and you have money coming in, you want to dedicate yourself to only revenue generating tasks, such as managing the ads. You want to fill all these other seats with people that'll do that work for you. And that's the best way how to scale. That's how you really turn on the flywheel, and that's how you really scale up. Anyways, I hope this video helped you guys with what dropshipping actually is and how you can realistically start in 2021. And it, yes, is still 100%, you know, 100% profitable business model. It's probably one of my favorite business models. It's really what I've done for the last 4 years now, and it's really what I can't see myself doing anything else, just because it's so fun. But you have to go through these barriers, like I said. But once you do, and you just make a killing of it, honestly, it gets so much easier, and it's just so worth it. So yeah, dudes, go out there, start testing, open up the stores you closed before, start turning the ads back on, and start making some sales. Peace out.